So you've realized that your Osmo Action is actually a great vlogging camera. If you haven't, you should check this video out up here. But although the inbuilt microphone on the Osmo Action is, well, it's all right, you're looking to level up your audio without having to pay Rode prices. Yeah, me too. And I may just have the answer. This is the Micmov V2. It's a small condenser mic with a super cardioid pattern and doesn't require batteries. Bonus. What's more, the equivalent from Rode, the Video Mic Go, comes as standard with just one simple TRS cable for £55 on Amazon. For the version with a TRRS cable, so you can use it with a phone, we're talking £64.90. In comparison on price alone, this little guy is currently selling for less than 30 quid with both of those cables. Now, I don't have the Rode version to compare, but I'm pretty sure you're going to be impressed with the results. First off, it comes in a handy little carry case, always love a case. And included in the kit first off is a phone holder with a cold shoe mount on top and a small little tripod to use with it. Now I'm not going to be using this mic with a phone in this video, but just FYI, it's not the most sturdy of small tripods, but we'll certainly get the job done with a phone. I just wouldn't put anything heavier than a standard phone in there. No shade, I wasn't expecting any kind of phone holder or tripod to begin with. There's also a dead cat for wind reduction. The mic itself, which you can see has both a line out for the microphone itself and also a headphone monitoring jack. It's also a metal body. Did not expect that. There's the TRS and TRRS cables and are nicely labelled with which end will go into the microphone and which to go into your camera or smartphone. And finally, the plastic shock mount with a cold shoe mount below. Now at first I felt I was trying to place the shock mount on the wrong part of the mic and it seemed it needed, well, quite a bit of force with the plastic not feeling like it was too malleable. Quick check of the images and yep, that's where it goes. Got to apply that force. So let's get together just the parts we need to upgrade the Osmo Action's audio. The dead cat, the mic with the shock mount, and the standard TRS cable. Now as you can see, we've got a case for the Osmo that has a hot shoe mount on the top to take the shock mount of the mic. I'll leave a link below for that if you need one. It's relatively inexpensive. Also, the Osmo needs the USB Type-C adapter to take an external audio source. I'll leave a link below for that too. Obviously, regardless of what external mic you're going to be using with the Osmo, you're going to need these two things. Taking a quick look at the Osmo, you're going to need to remove the door that covers the SD card slot and the USB Type-C port to be able to plug in the adapter. So it goes without saying, although I'm still going to say it, that this will now render your Osmo Action not waterproof. At least for as long as the door is removed. So with the door off, the Osmo back in the cage and the adapter plugged in, all that's left to do is slide the Micmov V2 on the top, connect the TRS cable, and we're away. So seeing as though we're all in lockdown here in the UK, I thought I'd do the test in my garden. There is a bit of a breeze coming over. The way that these houses are all laid out, any kind of breeze and this kind of becomes like a bit of a wind tunnel. I've noticed because I filmed out here before, there is a slight breeze going across, but this is the built-in mic of the Osmo Action. Let's just see, because there were some times on the West Island Way where ambient noises around us really kind of ruined the, or yeah, made the audio hard to edit with, either wind or surrounding, I don't know, water cascading or something. That really did kind of make the audio not necessarily unusable, but just not optimal. So let's switch to the mic that's on top. And now we have the mic on top. The breeze has stayed the same. I am holding the mic at the exact same distance, and the dead cat is on top of the microphone. The microphone is about, what, maybe about a foot and a half away from me. If I push a little bit further away, that should still be able to be picking me up all right. I'm not talking stupidly loud. It is a Sunday morning here, so don't really want to be annoying the neighbors. That wind is starting to pick up a little bit. I don't think any kind of dead cat will be able to completely get rid of that, but let's see how well that does. Let me switch that around, see if that makes any difference. It's got a bit of a fold in it, so I had it going up and down. I've now turned it to go left to right. So let's see if that has any change or not. Just really talking so you can hear it. Don't really have much else to say, really. That's a first. Yeah, you're telling me. As you can tell, the Micmod V2 made a huge difference to the audio being captured by the Osmo Action. A real upgrade on an already pretty okay inbuilt mic. If you'd like to hear more audio being captured from the Micmod V2 to really help you decide whether you think it's a capable enough mic for you, well, just go back to watch this video again, because every bit of it has been recorded with the Micmod V2. Huh, plot twist. Link in the description if you fancy picking up one of these little fellas, along with all the extra bits I've listed in the video. Please do drop a like on this video if you've enjoyed it, if you found it helpful, or both. It really, really does help out the channel. But as always, my name's Adam, this is Music of a Man. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you on the next one.